An ecosystem refers to a community of living organisms interacting with each other and their physical environment. These interactions form a complex network of relationships where energy and nutrients are exchanged and recycled. Each ecosystem is unique and characterized by its specific combination of biotic and abiotic factors. In this video, we will create an ecosystem together. Let's get started. Welcome to Piece of Nature. I created this ecosystem for my friend 2 years ago. As you can see, all the plants have withered, and there's no life left inside. It's been like this for 365 days. It's time to start a new life. First, I'm emptying everything inside. I made this enclosure out of plexiglass. Comparing plexiglass to glass, plexiglass is more prone to scratching and flexible. Its flexibility is a disadvantage for such systems because when we put materials inside, it becomes heavier, causing the lid especially to warp over time. In my opinion, the only advantage of plexiglass over glass is that it's lighter. I'm leaving the background as it is, because if I try to remove it, the plexiglass will likely break. I'm using these small river gravels to ensure drainage. To prevent the soil from mixing with the drainage layer, I'm placing a weed barrier between them. For a terrarium, it's best to use a well-draining soil mix that's formulated specifically for terrariums or houseplants. A typical mix consists of potting soil, perlite, and peat moss or coconut coir in equal parts. This mixture provides adequate drainage while retaining some moisture, which is ideal for most terrarium plants. Additionally, you can add a layer of activated charcoal at the bottom of the terrarium to help keep the soil fresh and prevent odors. I also painted the parts that look bad from the outside with black acrylic paint. It has a nicer appearance now. My favorite part is always planting. Creating a good landscape gives me great pleasure. Terrariums creates a humid environment, so I choose plants that tolerate or even prefer higher humidity levels. I'm considering the growth habits of the plants. I selected a mix of trailing, upright, and bushy plants to create visual interest and fill out the terrarium nicely. These plants that are relatively low maintenance and don't require frequent pruning or grooming. This makes it easier to care for terrarium over time. I ensure that the plants I choose are compatible in terms of their growth rates and water requirements. I avoid combining plants that have significantly different needs to prevent one species from overpowering the others. I experiment with a variety of shapes, textures, and colors to create an aesthetically pleasing display. I mix foliage plants with different leaf shapes and colors for a dynamic look. By considering these factors, you can choose the right plants for your terrarium that will thrive in its environment and create a beautiful, balanced miniature ecosystem. Moss adds a lush, green carpet-like appearance to terrariums, creating a natural and visually appealing landscape. They help retain moisture in the soil, creating a humid microclimate that benefits moisture-loving plants. Moss helps regulate humidity levels within the terrarium by absorbing and releasing moisture, which can be beneficial for plants that prefer higher humidity. Also, they provide a natural habitat for small invertebrates such as springtails and isopods, which help break down organic matter and contribute to the ecosystem. Dried leaves create shaded areas on the soil surface, preventing overheating of the soil and helping to distribute moisture evenly. They also provide food for small creatures living inside, such as springtails and isopods. Additionally, they contribute to the natural appearance of our ecosystem. Springtails and isopods break down organic matter into smaller particles, facilitating the release of nutrients back into the soil. This helps to replenish essential nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, which are crucial for plant growth. As these organisms burrow through the soil, they create passageways that improve soil aeration. This allows oxygen to penetrate deeper into the soil, promoting healthier root growth and enhancing overall soil structure. They can break down certain toxins and pollutants present in the soil, helping to detoxify the environment and reduce the harmful effects of contaminants on plants and other organisms. Their activities stimulate microbial populations in the soil, enhancing microbial diversity and activity. This can lead to increased nutrient availability and improved soil fertility. Overall, springtails and isopods play vital roles in maintaining the health and functioning of terrestrial ecosystems, contributing to biodiversity, nutrient cycling, and soil quality. You can find the video about how I created this aquarium, which is the largest ecosystem I've ever made, on my channel. You can also see the current videos of this ecosystem on my Instagram account. Well-balanced aquarium water is generally beneficial for house plants. It typically contains the necessary nutrients and minerals in appropriate concentrations for plant growth. A well-balanced aquarium environment provides plants with essential elements like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and trace minerals, which are crucial for their development. I use aquarium water for all my house plants in terrestrial ecosystems. If you have an aquarium at home, try it out. You'll see its benefits. In the upcoming seconds, you will see the final state of the ecosystem. As always, thank you very much for watching this video. Peace and love.